So in continuation to lecture 5, design problem part 1, in lecture 5 we have calculated bending moment coefficients as well as shear force coefficients from table number 12 and 13, IS 456. After that we have calculated maximum bending moment in two terms, that is positive bending moment as well as negative bending moment. Positive bending moment we have calculated at the middle of the span, and negative bending moment we have calculated at a section near to support. So let us continue the design problem. This is lecture number 6, part 2. So step number 5, we are continuing from the previous lecture, where we refer clause 22.5.1, table number 12 and table number 13. Maximum positive factored bending moment we have calculated, that is equal to 243.21 kilonewton meter. Maximum negative factored bending moment is 282 kilonewton meter. Maximum shear force at support section, that is equal to 201.6 kilonewton. Now step number 6. In step number 6 we will be checking the limiting moment of a resistance. That means we will be calculating limiting moment of a resistance for the given details as per IS 456, so that we can check whether the bending moment which we have calculated in step number 5 is more than limiting moment of a resistance or less than limiting moment of a resistance. So here we are referring clause number G1.1 of IS 456 from annexure G. And for steel of grade Fe415 and concrete of grade M20, we have taken this formula, that is MU limited is equal to 0.138 FCK VD square, and putting all the details we get MU limited is equal to 350 kilonewton meter. So it is very much clear that MU maximum which we have calculated in step number 5 is less than MU limited. So Codal guideline is followed here, and as per clause G1.1, when MU maximum is less than MU limited, the section is under reinforced, and as per Codal advice we have to prefer the section which is under reinforced. Now let us go to step number 7, calculation of mean reinforcement. So here we will be able to calculate mean reinforcement required to take care of positive bending moment, that is 243.21, negative bending moment, that is 282 kilonewton, and for these bending moment we will calculate the main steel required, that means area of steel required at the middle of span as well as at a section at the supports, from which we will be working out how many bars, that means number of bars required to get this much area of steel, which we will calculating in step number 7. So here we can refer clause G.1.1 part B from annexure G. By using this formula, that is for under reinforced section, this formula is given, and from this formula, by putting all the details whatever we have, we will be able to make an equation to calculate area of steel AST required. So first point will be area of steel for negative bending moment, that is at support section. So negative bending moment, as we have calculated in step number 5, it is 282 kilonewton. So this 282 kilonewton we have taken, and after putting all the values we will be getting a quadratic equation. And when we solve this quadratic equation, we will be getting two values of area of steel, and whichever the lesser value we will be taking, so that our section is under reinforced as well as economical. So here we have worked out AST is coming out to be near to 1420, so we have taken the value 1420 millimeter square. Now this much area of steel is required at the support section. So let us provide 4 number of bars of 22 mm dia, that is HYST bars. So area provided will be 1520, which is greater than 1420, so it's okay. And we have to provide at tension phase near supports. Now point 2, area of steel required to take care positive bending moment at the bottom of the beam. Bottom of the beam, we have to provide the steel to take care of positive bending moment. So here positive bending moment was 243.21 kilonewton meter. So by using the formula and after solving this equation, AST is coming out 1190 millimeter square. So let us provide again 4 number of bars of 20 mm dia, and AST provided for positive bending moment 1256 millimeter square at the bottom of the beam, that means near the bottom of the beam. So now after calculation of area of steel required, we have to take care of shear force. So for that, first of all we will be checking whether shear reinforcement need to be designed or whether minimum reinforcement, that means nominal shear reinforcement, is required. So go to clause number 40 of IS-456, where all the details and guidelines how to calculate, how to provide shear reinforcement is clearly mentioned. So first of all, let us calculate nominal shear stress. Nominal shear stress means how much shear stress is coming at the section due to shear force. So by using this formula, which is given in clause number 40, you will be able to get this value. So tau V is coming out to be 1.034 Newton per millimeter square. So this much is the shear stress coming on the section. Now we have to check whether our section, based on all the details whichever we have decided, is able to resist this shear stress or not. Now first of all, we will be calculating the area of steel, that means percentage of steel which you have provided at support section. So percentage of steel coming out to be 0.78%, and based on this value and referring table number 19, we can find out the value of tau C. Tau C mean if this much steel is provided, based on the steel, based on the beam dimensions, that is we are putting RCC beam. So tau C mean how much shear stress this section can resist without providing any shear reinforcement. So tau C is coming out to be 0.5672. But here shear force or shear stress coming on the section is 1.034. So that means nominal shear stress which is coming on the section is more than the shear resisting capacity of the section. So that means we have to design the shear reinforcement as per caudal provision. Here let me explain again. Tau C is the shear stress resisting capacity of the section itself, that means with the help of concrete and steel. And tau V is the stress coming due to the loads. Here tau V is more than tau C, so we have to design the shear reinforcement in the section. So how much shear force will be responsible for providing shear reinforcement, or in other language we can say we have to design the shear reinforcement, and this shear reinforcement is designed to carry out this much balance shear. Balance shear mean whatever be the total shear force coming on the section minus whatever be the shear force resisting capacity of the section without shear reinforcement. So remaining 90.99 kilonewton, this is the balance shear, and for this balance shear we have to design the shear reinforcement. So again let us explain, this 201.6 kilonewton is the shear force coming on the section due to the various loads, and this calculation here, whatever with this shear force, this is the shear force resisting capacity of the section. So shear force coming on the section is more than shear force resisting capacity of the section. So this much is the balance shear force for which we have to design the shear reinforcement. So here we will providing 8 mm dia, two legged stirrups, that is our own choice whether we have to use 8 mm or 10 mm. And for trial we are using 8 mm diameter two legged stirrups at a spacing, center to center spacing of 200 mm. Now this 200 mm spacing in code guideline is given, one formula is given from where you can calculate SV, that means spacing between the shear stirrups which you are providing. But as we are aware that shear force is maximum at the supports, and beyond the support, that means towards the span of the beam, shear force is getting reduced. So the requirement of shear stirrups in the span section will be less. So that's why we have increased spacing between the stirrups when you move towards the center of the span, because at the center of span only bending moment is maximum but shear force is minimum. So when you are increasing the spacing between the stirrups, that means in particular maybe in a unit length of the beam, reinforcement, shear reinforcement will be lesser if spacing is more, and shear reinforcement will be more if spacing is less. So spacing we have increased, that means near the support section shear reinforcement is having more area of steel as compared to shear reinforcement at the middle of the section. Now step number 9, here we have to check the section for deflection. So that is known as deflection control check. By referring clause number 23.2, we are getting this formula. That means at the center of span where deflection is supposed to be maximum, so what will be the L by D maximum value? That is given by this formula, L by D basic. You may be remembering L by D basic is given in the code, therefore different type of support, that means simple support beam, cantilever, as well as continuous. So some L by D ratio is given, and we will be using that L by D ratio. And when you go through the clause 23.2 carefully, you will be finding some modification factors are mentioned. So this formula we have to use here, KT, KC and KF are the modification factors. For detailed understanding, you refer this clause carefully. Now, percentage of steel which we have provided at the center of span, so that percentage of steel after this formula is worked out to be 0.66%. Now we have to refer figure number 4 in IS 456, and from that figure number 4 we will be getting modification factor KT approximately equal to 1.1. Now we will be neglecting, for simplicity we will be neglecting bars in compression side, so taking KC and KF is equal to 1. So using this formula we are able to get L by D maximum, that is 28.6 as per caudal provision. Now we have to check L by D ratio in actual which we have provided. So L by D ratio actual is coming out to be 12.3. Now it is less than the restriction applied by code. So we can say our section is satisfying the deflection control criteria. Now, very important section of the design problem is detailing of the bars, detailing of the steel which we are providing. So as you know that near the support section at the top level we have to provide negative reinforcement, but as you move from the support section towards middle, bending moment is changing from negative to positive. So at the middle of the section, or throughout the you can say bottom of the section, we will be providing reinforcement, positive reinforcement, and at support section we will be providing negative reinforcement. But this negative reinforcement we need to cut, and that is known as curtailment of steel bars, because beyond this it is decided that negative bending moment effect will be negligible, or there will not be effect of the negative bending moment. So we will be curtailing the steel bars which we have provided in the top section of, that is support section at a top level. So for this we have to refer, for design detailing we have to refer SP34 1987, and this is figure number 8.5 we have taken from SP34, that is curtailment rule for continuous beam. Now let us make it more simplified with this figure. Now here you can see easily this portion where now I am pointing out, this is the support, and above this white color section this is the beam section. So at support section we need negative reinforcement, but if you are providing negative reinforcement in different layers, so we can curtail this reinforcement. Now how? Let us suppose AST is the total area of steel which is required for negative bending moment at the support section. So 20% of the area, that means 20% of the bars we will be taking throughout the span length, and approximately 60% you will be taking up to 0.25 L1 from the face of support, and remaining steel you can cut at a length of 0.15 L1. So let us discuss the design detailing diagram for this particular problem which we are solving. Now let us understand step by step. So listen carefully. Now this black section which we have drawn, this rectangle is basically the beam section, continuous beam section, and these number 1, number 2, number 3 and number 4, these are the four simple supports. So this is the section, this is the first step. Now second step, let us write the dimensions. So this is the overall depth of section, beam section, with that we have decided it is 700 millimeter, and center to center of the support, that means span length from center to center, is 8000 millimeter, 8 meter, because in our case it is a continuous beam of equal spans. So second step is okay. Now third step, let us talk about the reinforcement. So first of all, let us talk about positive bending moment. And for positive bending moment, we have calculated 4 number of bars are required of 20 mm. We have provided 4 number of bars, 20 mm. So this red line is showing the reinforcement, that is the positive reinforcement throughout the span. These are 4 bars of 20 mm dia. So next is negative reinforcement. For negative reinforcement, we have decided that we will provide negative reinforcement at the top section. So in calculation, we have calculated that negative reinforcement, we will provide 4 bars of 22 mm dia. And for simplicity, we are taking 2 bars of 22 mm dia. Out of 4, 2 bars we will extend it throughout the span. This red color steel bars are negative reinforcement, and 50% we are taking for easiness, because if number of bars are more, suppose 8 bars like that heavy reinforcement, then we can curtail. But here we need not to curtail as per exactly as per SP 34. For simplicity, we can be using here. So now remaining 2 bars of negative reinforcement, here we will curtail these 2 bars. So as per SP 34, approximately from the face of the support, we are extending, or you can say negative reinforcement, which is shown with black color. These are 2 bars of 22 mm dia, and we are cutting these bars at a distance 2000 mm from the face of the support along both sides. So we are providing negative reinforcement that is equal to length 2000 plus 2000 plus width of the support. In this problem, since width of support is not mentioned, if it is mentioned, then you can easily decide what is the length of the negative. That means when you have to make the bar bending schedule, then you can find out the length of the steel bar here, which you have to provide. So it is very much clear for negative reinforcement, 2 bars are extended throughout the span, and 2 bars at the support we are curtailing, which are shown as black colored. So next step is shear reinforcement. Here you remember in the previous step where we have calculated shear reinforcement, we have decided that shear reinforcement will be 8 mm dia, 2 legged vertical stirrups having center to center spacing of 200 mm near to support section. So here if you can see here shear reinforcement, that is of blue color. Now blue color shear reinforcement, that means shear stirrups of blue color are provided near the support as at a spacing of 200 mm, and at the middle of the section, as we have decided that we will be providing shear stirrups at a spacing of 300 mm. So we are showing here with black color. So these black color shear stirrups are having spacing of 300 mm. So these vertical lines indicate the shear stirrups. So we have mentioned here that 8 mm dia 200 mm, and these black 8 mm dia of 300 mm center to center spacing. Now let us understand more effectively by taking 2 sections, section AA at the middle of the span and section BB at the center of the support. Now this diagram is showing section taken at that is section AA taken at the mid of the span. So this will be the beam section. 300 mm is the width, 700 mm is the overall depth. Now two bars at the top we have provided. These two bars are of 22 mm. So that means these two bars are, you can say, these two bars I have shown here. Now when you cut the section, you cut these two bars as well as four bars at bottom. So section of the four bars are shown at the bottom, that is four number of bars of diameter 20 mm. Now this black color, that is 8 mm dia, it is center to center spacing of 300 mm. This is the shear stirrups which you have provided. So shear stirrup will be surrounding the main reinforcement. Now we have to understand this section BB, which we have taken at the support. Now if you start from the top, you will be seeing that your section is cutting first of all the section of that is beam. So this is the section beam. Then red color bars are cut, that are red color are two bars of 22 mm dia which are extended throughout the span. After that black color bar are cut, black color bar are curtailed bars, that is two bars of 22 mm dia. Now 50 mm is the effective cover from the top and 50 mm is the effective cover from the bottom. So in between, you can say depth of the beam is 600 remaining. And these shear stirrups are 8 mm dia, 200 mm, because we are taking section at the support level or support section. So where we have provided shear stirrups at a spacing of 200 mm. So all these details you have to clearly shown on the steel diagram, that means reinforcement diagram detailing, you have to clearly mention. If there is any fault or any deficiency, then the person at the site who has the responsibility of execution work, then his work will be delayed if your detailing is not clearly mentioned. So go through the video lecture carefully. Many times you can go through the video lecture, and whatever be your queries or your doubts, feel free to write your queries or doubts in the comment section of the YouTube video. We will be uploading this video on the YouTube channel. Thank you.